Hello everybody, this is Bitcoin Macro, and on this video guys I'm going to talk about the most recent listings on Coinbase Pro of Barnbridge, Livebeer and Quant. I have covered at least two of these coins, Livebeer and Quant, several times before. At least Quant, I have been shilling it on Twitter, Telegram and TradingView for quite some time because it has been one of the most bullish coins out there. But at the moment I also like Livebeer because it has been getting more and more listings, and I think Quant is going to get more listings as well. But I would like to cover a little bit more about Barnbridge, at least the technical stuff. Now, before I get into the video, guys, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. You can also click the bell icon to get notifications for videos like this. And also, please remember to follow me on Twitter, Telegram, and TradingView, because again, that's where I was sharing Quant before it had the big pump. And of course, you might have seen the videos where I talked about these coins before, but I think this one might be much better. At least it will give you a much better idea of where things are at the moment. So I'm going to start with Livebeer because I like the chart and I have some extra information on it straight away. Because look guys, in my opinion, Livebeer could come all the way up to this level, which is the main resistance level, at least that exists on the BTC chart. And I'm going to look at the USD chart as well for those that always scream, why am I looking only at BTC charts? And the truth is I'm looking at BTC charts because there is more history. And at least at times like this, when Bitcoin drops a lot, I want to see how that coin looks relative to Bitcoin and how strong it is in general. Now, for Livebeer, we have had the listing on Binance, we had the listing on Kraken, we have had the listing on KuCoin that just happened yesterday. We also had the listing on Coinbase Pro, which all of these together are quite massive. Okay, now Livebeer is also listed on Poloniex, maybe has been listed on some other exchanges, and I haven't realized maybe Huobi is coming next. Oh, I forgot OKX. Exactly, OKX as well. So who knows, maybe more exchanges will follow soon. Of course, most of them have already listed it, but because, you know, once major exchanges start listing, especially when they start listing bearish coins, grayscale coins, which, like, you know, Barry is a big investor in these things, then we might see them do much better. So they have an extra bid. And now, because Livebeer has had found support over this level right there, like, we can see that this essentially switched into pretty strong support overall. And once everything crashed, Livebeer had a strong bounce, a much stronger bounce, made a new high, at least in Bitcoin terms, and then it has been kind of chopping, has dropped a little bit, but it's still above some key support. Now, Livebeer had this massive capitulation over here, and I've switched into log chart, but look at this, guys. So Livebeer had dropped about 99% from its all-time high in BTC terms. It dropped from its June highs after the, or at least during the summer alt season, the DeFi season, like many call it, you know, it dropped 92%. So it was already beaten up so badly. And then look at what happened. We make a low, then it starts bleeding more and more and more. And then we have the big news of Grayscale, of not exactly Grayscale listing it, but maybe Grayscale listing it and having that product. And then it got added on Grayscale and had that massive pump because it was a much smaller coin. It was one of the smallest coins added on Grayscale. So we have that nice choppy area down here, and then boom, higher. Now, I don't know if, you know, we're just going to get a big bear market and everything crashes in Bitcoin terms, or Bitcoin crashes and everything crashes with it. But I think that what's going to happen next is potentially Bitcoin going higher and alts slowly bleeding in BTC terms. However, there will be some alts that have really strong fundamentals, and Livebeer has strong fundamentals. And I'm not going to go through everything because I want to keep the video short, but it's one of those rising stars, I would say. You know, it's just one of those coins that has a lot of technical developments and a lot of stuff going on for it. And it has been getting more and more adoption, which in my opinion is what will differentiate many coins at the moment, because liquidity does matter and matters the most. But another fundamental that really differentiates projects, especially in bear markets, or at least maybe, you know, in between alt seasons, because alts bleed a lot versus BTC or USD, depending on whether we are in a bull market or bear market, So those with strong fundamentals are definitely ones that I would like to look at, because, you know, if you look at Theta, it has been one of those live streaming, like live video and stuff like that, like storage and so on, like YouTube style decentralized places, you know. So Theta has been the main leader and has had the most growth, but who knows, maybe LivePair will also follow Theta to an extent. They are not exactly the same, they're not the same, but at least those types of platforms might get more and more adoption because people want to get away from centralized content providers. So to me, first target might be around 13,000 satoshis, which is about a double or more from here. At least that's the first one. Maybe second one would be around 20,000 satoshis, and then the final targets over there, which would complete the cycle to an extent, would be at around 30,000 satoshis, which is a really long term target. Like, that would be a massive run up from here, so I'm not expecting it to go straight away. Now, if it dips all the way down here, I'll definitely be buying, because coins that have gotten all those listings, it didn't really moon as much as others, and at least they haven't broken some really important levels, I'm interested in them. Now, of course, LivePair has gone up 27x, 28x from its all-time low. Maybe I should adjust this a little bit to be more exact. Yeah, about 28x. So, because it had that very strong capitulation, I think it might be a little different. And I'm not saying it's going to be too different, but at least to me, these coins that had such strong capitulations, and think about this, guys, this coin came right at the bottom of 2018. So if that coin drops so much versus Bitcoin during a bear market, after launching in a bear market and dumping so much, you know, this might be even more bullish for this coin. Now let's get a little bit onto some other stuff, but start from LivePair USD. Let's see what it shows here on Poloniex. And the truth is that it doesn't look very pretty. Let's have a look at the 4-hour, because it's usually a little bit cleaner. So where did we get that top? It was right here. Maybe just put on the 12-hour and see where the bottom was. So as you can see, the bottom was pretty much exactly where those highs were, and that's pretty nice and healthy. However, it's still kind of, so it did come and test the previous all-time high as well. So that's pretty good, although it probably didn't come exactly to this level. Still pretty nice. And here we do see that it's showing some strength. It's finding support close to those previous support levels right here. And although the structure isn't all that bullish, it could have a nice bounce over here. I do believe, however, that it could potentially come back down to those highs to start to the place where it started pumping very hard. I don't know how, I don't know when will that happen, but it will potentially eventually happen. Now, if we start seeing new highs, maybe it will go very, very well. But for now, potentially those all-time highs around here would act as resistance. Now, the next one, which is one of my favorites, is going to be Quant. It's going to be QNT, which has had one of the most beautiful charts I have seen, have ever seen, at least in Bitcoin terms, because look at this, guys. It has been like proper accumulation for a very, very long time. So it started from a very low point, had a very significant pump, but for many years, like probably 2+ years, it has been going sideways versus Bitcoin. So it hasn't really broken that low or those lows. So it has been every time been holding those lows and actually going up from them. And every time it has been coming to those highs, it has been rejected. And this time around, what happened was Coinbase added Quant to its custody solution around the time that the crash happened. So Bitcoin had already started turning down, but this one got listed on Coinbase custody. It was added on Coinbase custody, so then it had that really big crash along with the rest of the market, at least on the second leg down. And it came down to the volume profile point of control. I think at least this is potentially one of those. There was a stronger one down here, but actually touched the most important level, and it bounced very nicely because that was both resistance, it was also an accumulation zone that acted as support, plus the volume profile point of control, or at least a high volume node over here. And then I started seeing it break higher. It slowly started having that accumulation over here. It had another point where it seemed like it wanted to go up, but because things weren't going well with other coins, it also felt some pain. So, you know, it held a little lower for some time. And then what I had said was, you know, these levels right here were very important. We did see it slowly go higher and higher over there, and at some point we had the second crash with the crash of Bitcoin on the 22nd, or at least shouldn't say crash, but it dipped to 29k where it bottomed. That one also bottomed. That was about the same time it got listed on Coinbase Pro, or at least it happened around 20,000 satoshis, and then it had the final leg up. Currently it doesn't look that bad, but it doesn't look that great either. It seems like it's showing some strength. However, in my opinion, it could potentially come back down to 13,000 satoshis or something like it. There are tons of good things going for this coin, so I shouldn't say I'm not very bearish, but if things, you know, go badly for the entire market, I'm not gonna sit here and be like this coin is the best, because of course since the beginning of May, it pretty much actually in Bitcoin terms went up 4x, 4.5x, something like that. That's quite significant. And of course, you know, it has been one of those coins that since like forever, it hasn't really had a dip. So it's been making new all-time highs versus Bitcoin. And it's one of the old coins, actually. Although it came into the bear market, it has been going, has been doing very, very well. And of course, there are many things that people are saying about CBDCs and quant and interoperability of blockchains. And I've heard many good things about quant, and many of them probably hold true. And one of the things that I like is that they haven't been pushing for listings on exchanges. So the main listings that I think kind of started tipping the scale for quant was the listing for on KuCoin and Gate, while before that it was only listed on Bittrex and some really small exchanges, nothing really special. But you know, now that it has gotten those listings and it has been going up very nicely, I do expect very big things from it. Of course, it might pull back down, but I do expect the whole area from 8,000 satoshis to about, you know, maybe I should say 13,000 satoshis to act as support. I do expect maybe a little chop in this area, but you know, dips on this coin are definitely to be bought. And because, you know, it has been only listed on Coinbase Pro, and I do believe Binance, Gemini and many others will follow. So that's it for this coin. Let's have it, at least in BTC terms, let's have a look at USD terms. And it's been like a very strong uptrend, guys. Look at how nicely this level here was formed. Then we had the breakout in January, went up very, very nicely. Look at that nice base over here. It's been going up very nice and steady since its inception, like a very strong bull market. And if we just have a look at this, that was essentially when it got listed on KuCoin. It got listed on KuCoin when it started topping, around, you know, the beginning of February. And look at this massive support, had one crash, so it swept those lows over here, then it actually came back above it, that support turned back into support. We saw the same thing again with the accumulation bottom of Bitcoin, then started trying to break higher again. Once it broke higher and dropped back down to this area, held very nicely. So who knows, for now this looks like very nice support, but although, like, you know, if it comes back down here, I want to be buying. If it drops all the way down here, I want to buy even more. I don't really believe it's going to crash to $18-$17 yet, but it is a probable scenario. It's not very unlikely if we have a bear market, a proper bear market, but you know, that's up to debate. So let's have a look at the Barn Bridge token. Now this doesn't look very clean, because I don't really have a proper chart. Maybe I should use something else, but to me that looks decent. So this one had a very strange crash after its trading got launched, and it didn't do very well during this bull market. Only went up about 500% from its lowest point. And you know, that lowest point came after Bitcoin was already going higher, so everything was doing very well and this one was doing very badly. But the good thing about this coin is that it has been essentially into accumulation for quite some time, because it has had that sideways movement. It got listed on Gemini, it has been listed on several other exchanges along with Coinbase Pro. I don't really know much about this project, so I'm not really going to tell you guys stuff I don't know. But to me, it's looking like an interesting chart in USD terms, although right after the Coinbase listing, it got crashed very, very badly. So if we get a bear market, clearly this is going to suffer along with the rest of the coins. But for now, it's looking like it is in a sideways accumulation. So maybe at some point it will get all the way up to 125 or more. Now let's have a look at Bond, at Barnbridge in BTC terms. I don't know if I can find an interesting one. If I can find a really good one, let's just divide this with BTC USDC so that we can get the actual BTC chart. And as you will see here, guys, it has been going sideways in BTC terms as well, because of course Bitcoin has gone up and down. It has returned back to the same place before the alt season started, or about the same place the alt season started. It's probably a little higher at the moment, but overall it's still pretty low. And you can see that this is pretty cheap, at least versus where it was when it's listing, where at least it started trading on Uniswap. So to me, this one, if it starts going higher, it's definitely one I want to keep paying attention to. Although I do believe this resistance is probably going to hold for a little bit. But if I see this kind of thing right here, test the resistance, have a little dip, and then slowly start breaking out, I'm going to get very bullish, and then every retest I want to buy. Now, I don't know if we're going to get straight into a bull market right away, guys. Maybe we do get more chop. I do believe alts need some extra time, but who knows? These coins that get more and more listings, these coins that have a lot of attention because a lot of people like them, are definitely some coins that we need to be paying attention to and keep track of, because you know, anything Coinbase lists, and especially stuff that haven't done well before, they are definitely worth paying attention. Because look, if a coin gets listed on Coinbase that has gone up a lot and its chart looks a little bit like a topped altcoin, for example, let's say if Coinbase lists something that has gone up massively and has had a blow off top, then these projects don't really tend to do well. Some examples might be like, I should say, NMR, which is a coin that Coinbase listed. And you know, since the listing on Coinbase, which came around this level right here on the at the end or middle of August, you know, that coin went straight down. It didn't really do very well. At least it did well, but it didn't do very well relative to other coins. Maybe it does well at some point, but you know, many of these coins that go listed on Coinbase after big pumps, they tend to do not very well. So that's it for me, guys. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Also, leave a comment down below. Tell us what you like. Tell us what you don't like about the videos. You can also tell us, you can just have some suggestions. Please don't really shill some really bad altcoins. Just give us some of your thoughts, maybe stuff that you want to hear about, something interesting happening to some coins. I will start sharing some videos about some other altcoins as well, which I find interesting, some gems as well. But you know, you can also follow me on Twitter, Telegram, and TradingView for more updates, because I have been talking a lot about Quant. I have spoken before about LivePeer, so that's why I didn't really rush into making a new video. I had spoken about all these listings about LivePeer before. I had explained that they were all coming. For Quant, I have made a video before. I did mention it in one of the shorter videos that I have been making, but I have been mentioning it quite a bit on my TradingView account and Twitter as well. So that's it for me, guys. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.